The research in breast cancer in neoadjuvant and adjuvant therapies revolves around several different components. Obviously, we're trying to combine known drugs in different ways, different doses, different schedules to maximize cure rate, minimize time on treatment, and minimize toxicity. The other big push in breast cancer and all cancers to date is this concept of what is known as personalized medicine. That is, are there characteristics of that patient's tumor that can help us give more specific therapies? In breast cancer, we're lucky to have several targeted agents, the two most common being the anti-estrogen pills that target the estrogen receptor of breast cancer, and Herceptin and other anti-HER2 drugs that target the HER2 pathway that stimulates breast cancer growth in those 25% of patients that overexpress the HER2 gene. Herceptin is by far the best anti-HER2 drug that we've found to date, but there's another drug, Tykerb, lapatinib, which is now commonly used, especially in metastatic breast cancer. One of the ongoing trials in neoadjuvant chemotherapy is asking the question, is it better or does it improve cure rates to combine two anti-HER2 drugs? That is lapatinib or Tykerb plus Herceptin. The data to that initially looks quite good. There was also a report in this week's San Antonio Breast Conference of another new anti-HER2 drug called Pertuzamab that, given in combination with Herceptin and with chemotherapy, improved response rates in patients with metastatic disease. There's also another anti-HER2 drug, a very interesting drug called T-DM1, that combines Herceptin and has attached a chemotherapy drug called Maytansine to the Herceptin molecule. The Herceptin then acts as a transport mechanism, so to speak, to take this chemotherapy molecule to the cancer cell, and one would hope have a higher kill rate with the T-DM1, that is the Herceptin chemotherapy conjugate, rather than Herceptin alone. And that's another drug that's coming down the pike, so to speak, that looks very exciting. Other areas of research are obviously newer drugs. Afinitor is what's called an mTOR inhibitor, targeting one of the other pathways of breast cancer growth that, again, in the recent San Antonio meeting, seemed to indicate that Afinitor in combination with hormone therapy may double the length of response to hormone therapy. There are innumerable targeted agents coming down the pike from various pharmaceutical companies looking at all of the different pathways that are involved in breast cancer growth. So I think that in the next 5 or 10 years, we can expect a multitude of new drugs, many of which are probably targeted to a small population of breast cancer patients based on measurement of their particular pathways, but that will ultimately be given in combination, and we would hope with less toxicity and higher cure rate.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.